Hello and welcome. This is Sarah Dresser, clinical hypnotherapist, and in this video I'm going to talk about how you can retrain or rewire the brain. Essentially, how to get your brain on your side again. So, as recently as 20 years ago, it was thought that the brain was fixed at birth, like bricks set in concrete. But the rise of neuroscience and the investment in longer-term studies showed that our brain can indeed change in our lifetime, at any point. This ability to change the brain is called neuroplasticity. So before I explain what happens in hypnotherapy, I'll quickly go over how brain cells form connections and how they communicate. How our brain cells communicate is through electrochemical signals, partly electrical as the signal travels inside a brain cell, and chemical to communicate between brain cells. So chains of electrochemical signals result in an emotional response, a thought, an action. And as the saying goes, neurons that fire together, wire together. So inside your brain, there are millions of pathways of brain cells that communicate together. And every time one of these pathways is activated, it ends in a resulting thought, feeling, or action. And the more we practice a thought, feeling, or action, the stronger that pathway becomes. So we can think of our regular habits like the highways of the brain. Super wide, very well developed, and very strong. So this is why the brain sometimes chooses a response that we don't like, simply because it literally is the road most traveled. So one of the ways that we can update the subconscious is with repetition, over and over and over. This has some success, but not always. If there is a deep-seated belief or trauma that needs healing, this requires a deeper therapy. Hypnotherapy is one of just a few styles of therapy that allows direct access to the subconscious. So what does happen in hypnotherapy and also in deep meditation? The first thing that happens is the brainwaves slow down. Normally, your brainwaves are at a speed that is called beta state, and in hypnosis, they slow down to theta. Theta triggers the relaxation of the critical mind. The critical mind acts as the gatekeeper to the subconscious. With the critical mind relaxed, we gain direct access to the subconscious. However, it is not just a question of access. Your subconscious has held onto these beliefs, these habits, these emotional responses for a long time. It still needs good reason to let go of them and to take on new beliefs. This is why I always say that all hypnosis is self-hypnosis. You will not believe simply because you are told to. So, if the therapist has done their work to understand your needs, your challenges, the brain can be open to change. And this may happen suddenly, in just one session, or slowly over time. There is no way to predict how quickly the changes will happen, or if they will happen at all. So what actually happens during hypnotherapy? What does it mean to retrain or rewire the brain? What actually happens in a state of hypnosis is the subconscious changes from read-only to read-write. If it receives enough information that convinces it to change, then new neural pathways are created, like new roads being built in a neighborhood. And as they continue to wire together, they become the stronger path. And as your old response or old belief or old action doesn't get exercised as much after hypnotherapy, just like a muscle that doesn't get exercised either, that old pathway that represents that old belief, thought, or response loses strength over time. And your new pathway becomes the default response, until they become part of your updated identity. And after that point, become self-reinforcing. So, with the power of hypnotherapy, you can choose responses that are in your best interests, that go beyond just surviving to thriving as an individual. If you like the idea of taking control of your brain again, feel free to check out my playlists on themes such as challenging emotions, self-esteem, learning to retrain the brain to sleep again, and more. And look out for the next video on the 5 main ways that we acquire trauma or limiting beliefs. Thank you for listening. My name is Sarah. And as always, I am here to support you on your journey to unlock your life.